Hey, Port City Church, Pastor Mark here, on location at our beautiful McGrath campus. I became the campus pastor here about 5 months ago already, and man, we're just having a good time. It's been some unique things happening, especially what we're finding ourselves in these days, such an unprecedented season. Just a couple days ago, Sunday, millions of people all around the world went to church in their living room. They sat in their pajamas. They had a cup of coffee or a glass of orange juice. They were gathered as families, as individuals or small groups. And man, I love it. Someone who is negative was saying, oh, the church is closing their doors. And someone very quickly responded and said, the church has no doors. And it's because it's made up of people, you and me, the people of God, who are the church of Jesus Christ. So it was just a great time. Hopefully you were able to watch and join us for that. We'll be doing that again this week. One of the things that's really important to us as a staff during a time like this is to stay connected with you, the people of Port City Church. We met for several hours on Monday morning, just working together, putting our heads together. It got a little goofy at times. It got kind of wacky at times. But one of the things that we are really passionate about is staying connected with you in this time. Let me just put it straight. We miss being together. We just hired a brand new worship pastor at McGrath campus. I'm going to introduce in a minute. He said to me, he goes, man, I'm going to miss leading worship. I just started here and I can't lead the people in worship. And man, we feel that. But we just want to have ways to stay connected with you in these next couple of weeks. So stay tuned. Bookmark our webpage. Check us out on Facebook. Daily, we're going to have video updates. It could be a devotional like today. What we have is a 7:38 daily devotional. Here's how this came about. We're in this staff meeting. We're talking about let's produce a daily word of encouragement, of hope to our people. And one of the questions was, well, what time should we post it? Steve says, I don't know, 7:38. I'm a literalist, so I think 7:38 on the dot. And that's where we're at. So every morning at 7:38, a new devotional will be posted by one of our staff members. Look forward to those. There's going to be times where you're going to hear some music that's posted by JP and Chandler and Maria, some other fun stuff just to get to know this team of people that make up the Port City Church staff. We're going to have a good time, but we want to stay connected. All right, let me introduce you to a couple people. Come on over here, guys.
Hey, what's up, everyone?
So, hey, we got our brand new worship pastor, his wife, Maria. They just moved here from Ohio. They've had two Sundays already with us, and they're gonna miss leading us over these next couple weeks. But you're gonna get to hear from them on some of the videos that we're gonna produce. But anyway, they actually match. They have a matching wardrobe. Since they are both incredibly musically and vocally talented, what I understand is their lives are a living musical. Is that right? Like all you do is just sing back and forth?
People do think that. Yeah. People do think
but that's how it is. High is that
musical,
true? Or?
I loved High School Musical growing up, so I could definitely... It's sometimes true.
Nice. Yeah. I'd like video of that. Yeah. So we're just looking forward to getting to know them more already. I love these two, and I'm so glad they joined our staff. Yeah. We're going to have just some great time in the months and years ahead of their ministry here. So thanks, guys, for being with us.
Thank you.
I'm going to hand the camera off to Chandler here so he can record a little bit more as we go on.
Oh, here we go. Oh, but it's not flipping, so we're just staying here.
All right. So... As we get into this devotional, each morning, these will be about 5 minutes long, so just bear with us. We're not trying to preach a full-length sermon to you. The other night, as things are unfolding, a bunch of things are on the news and cancellations and all these things, I woke up in the middle of the night with this verse on my mind, my heart is steadfast. And there are times where I wake up and those are things that happen to me and I sometimes get up and start looking through what is it that the Lord is putting on my mind. In this case, I dug up the psalm where that verse is found. And here, I want to put the verse up for you. This is David, who wrote most of the psalms. He writes this, my heart is steadfast, O God. My heart is steadfast. I will sing and make melody. Now, I want to focus on these words here right here. It's the word steadfast. That word literally means fixed. My heart is fixed on you, O God. I am focused. I am in position. I'm not moving. Okay? So when I look at this, all right, so David is saying, I'm fixed on you, God. I'm going to sing and make melody. If I didn't know any of the context behind this verse, I would think David's life is going pretty smooth right now. Things are going pretty well with David and his wife or his kids. Maybe his kids just got the Muskegon promise or maybe he just got some big promotion in the kingdom, right? Okay, so that's the time when we sing songs, when we're writing new songs and new melodies. But you know what? If you read the context of Psalm 57, it's not the case. Things were not going so well for David at this time. If you open your Bibles and you look through the Psalms, at the top of almost every Psalm is a heading. And that heading is there for a purpose so that we, the reader, can understand the setting and what's happening in that Psalm. Here's the heading for Psalm 57. It says, a miktam of David when he fled from Saul in the cave. Now that word miktam, a lot of scholars are kind of up in the air about what does this word really mean? Is it a song? Is it meant to be read as poetry? Several scholars agree that there's something unique about that word where it's almost like playing hide and seek. You know, when you're covering your face and you're counting to 10 and then it's time to go and find that secret place. A lot of scholars agree that there's something about Psalm 57 when this is called a miktam, that they refer to it as a secret. David has a secret that he knows to be true, and he's revealing it in the verses that follow. And here's what's going on. This is not being written while David is sitting in a powerful throne room ruling over the kingdom of Israel. This is written, he is fleeing from the current king, Saul, and he's hiding in a cave. And here's how the chapter starts. He says, be merciful to me, God. Be merciful to me, for in you my soul takes refuge. In the shadow of your wings, I will take refuge till the storms of destruction pass by. Last week, I talked about the eagle's wings, this notion of God being our protector, and he protects us underneath these mighty wings. In the shadow of your wings, I'm going to take refuge. And so that word steadfast, fixed, if we're under the protection of those wings, why would we want to go anywhere else other than his protection? And I'm going to wait there until the storms of destruction pass by. A few verses later, he says this about his enemies. They set a net for my steps. My soul was bowed down. They dug a pit in my way, but they have fallen into it themselves. And that's when he writes the verse, my heart is steadfast. Oh God, my heart is steadfast. I will sing and make melody. And so it's in the middle, this little secret of David's, this miktam, the secret that he wants to reveal to us is this. Storms are going to come. Trials are going to come. The enemy could be knocking at our door. They could be setting a net for our steps, digging a pit for us. But it's in those tests, in those trials that we can say, I'm going to be fixed on you, Jesus. How do we do that? Hopefully you have a Bible. Man, get into God's word more than you ever have. You're going to be exposed to some new worship songs from Chandler and Maria, from JP, other people on our team. Dive deeper into some of these new worship songs. These are incredible songs written based purely on scripture, put to music. Engage with God in that way. Come together in community in a way that you maybe never have. We've been given an incredible gift called time in this season. And so we want to offer some suggestions on how to use that time with your kids, how to use that time with family to connect with one another, go deeper in community, but use the time to be fixed, to be steadfast on our God. I want to close with one verse here. James 1:12, James says this, blessed is the man who remains, there's the word, who remains steadfast under trial. For when he has stood the test, he will receive the crown of life. Those are promises of reward that we get when we enter heaven, when we are with Jesus face to face, the promise of the crown of life, which God has promised to those who love him. So right now in this really unique time, uncertainty, a lot of people are panicking. We don't panic. God did not give us a spirit of fear, but of love and of self-control. And so we show love and care for our community instead of panic. When the anxiety seems to hit, be steadfast, fixed, focused on that relationship with Jesus Christ. Cling to him. He's going to prove himself in some incredible ways in the time that we're in. So ask him, God, show me yourself. Show me your ways. Do something really special, really unique in a time like this. We love you guys. We'll connect with you soon. Thanks.